absolutely fantastic to have you today at Birmingham Memorabilia. Have you been enjoying it so far?
It's a real pleasure. This is my first time in Birmingham, and it's been great. I mean, look around. Look around. Everybody's here. Aaron Douglas. See, I was tempted to do that on yours, but I said, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to be classy.
Well, nobody ever accused me of being classy.
Exactly. Ladies and gentlemen, Aaron Douglas. Yes, first time in Birmingham. Love it. It's a great event. It's a great opportunity to be here and meet the fans. And boy, are there ever a lot of them.
Lots of fans out there. Have you done a lot of these kind of conventions before? Have you met fans all over the place?
I have. I've been to several events that Brian has organized before. They've always been fantastic events. We used to do them at the Thistle down in Heathrow, and a few places around. I've been to Ireland a couple of times. It's the remarkable thing about Stargate is it's worldwide, and so I've traveled. I've had the opportunity to travel to some pretty wonderful places and meet fans from all walks of life, and what a tremendous treat that is.
Have there been any particularly memorable fan encounters, either funny ones or ones that have meant a lot to you?
Yeah, people that recognize you in men's washrooms. I was once on a bus in Vancouver and said, hey, and the guy right across the whole crowded bus is, aren't you the guy from Stargate Atlantis? So there's always some memorable fan encounters. What I find is...
Was he an old-timer prospector? Because he kind of sounded like, aren't you the young Jew, the one that...
What's remarkable about is the creativity of the fans. I mean, you walk around here and you just see how the people dress up and the fan art that is produced. It's a remarkable thing.
Stargate is a remarkable universe. People, like you say, love it all around the world. What do you think it is about this universe that captivated people in that way? Why did fans jump on board so quickly and so devotedly?
Well, I think the biggest asset that Stargate has was that it was sci-fi that didn't really take itself too seriously. It had a sense of humor about itself, and I think that's what people, when you come home on a Friday night after a long week at work, you put your feet up and you want to watch television, you want to be entertained. Everyone knows this is science fiction, that this is a story that's happening, so why not have some fun with it? And I think that was part of the DNA of Stargate, that is that it had a lot of fun with the genre, and that's a great credit to the writers for doing that. And I think that translates to sort of all the places that it travels to. People have talked about and appreciate the humor in the show, I think.
There's been a lot of different incarnations of Stargate, movies, television series, comic books. What do you think Stargate Atlantis specifically brought to the franchise?
I think Stargate Atlantis was the concept that we were isolated in a galaxy 60 million light years away gave it a kind of a bit of a bubble. It was in its own world, which was the magic of the show, I think, a lot in the beginning. Atlantis was also, it kind of carried on in the theme of SG-1. It had that same sort of sense of humor, but it kind of took it to a different sort of place with different different characters. But the fact that we had the Wraith and we had a different set of enemies, it was in some ways it was a much more evolved show, I think.
Now fans will have their favorite characters, apart from your own, of course. With any particular characters on the series that you just loved either watching or working with?
Oh, they were all great to work with. I mean, David Hewlett was a lot of fun to work with. It was a great crew and cast. Everybody says that but about the show that they're on, but it was truly true about Stargate. They had run for 10 years before we started, so it was a well-oiled machine, as Aaron had said previously. It really does... wonders to work on a show like that where the acting is appreciated, where the writing is good, and the fans appreciate it. You know, it really is a treat.
It's a series with great stars, great scripts. But what specifically about your character excited you when you started the role?
I like the idea of the internationalism of Atlantis. That there was characters. It was a Czech character that I was playing. That made it much more interesting, rather than, you know, the Americans are saving the world again. Not that there's anything wrong with Americans saving the world, but it's just nice to have it happen let other people have a go. Yeah, that's what I really liked about it. And I think that Paul McGillion, being Dr. Beckett, who was a Scottish scientist, kind of gave the international flavor, I think, a little bit to the expedition. So I think that was the contribution.
Fans will have their favorite episodes, their favorite story arcs. Are there any in particular that you're especially proud of or especially enjoyed making?
A lot of the mid-season breaks were a lot of fun to do. Those were usually double episodes that ended up being 7 or 8 months apart by the time the fans had seen them. Adrift was a particular episode that I really enjoyed doing, and most of the top of the season, season five, was tremendous episodes. So we've done, I'd say the cliffhangers at the when you never know what would happen. Those are always fun to do.